the vampire bats are probably one of the best examples of socialness in bats, sociality in bats, because they're so intelligent and they can form really strong bonds with each other. And it's very important for them because of how often they have to feed. So on average, a vampire bat can only go about 2 days without a meal because they only feed on blood and they don't have a way chemically to store blood as fat. So if a vampire bat comes back to the colony after a night of hunting and hasn't been able to find a meal, it could be in trouble. So it'll make this little begging motion. And then one of the other vampire bats that it has a strong bond with, a strong established bond, will scurry over and regurgitate, so throw up a little bit of the blood that they got that night, and the hungry bat will lick the blood out of its mouth. And I mean, it sounds gross, but that way both of those bats live through the night. And it's a tit-for-tat system. If I lend blood to you, there's an expectation that one day in return, you'll lend blood to me if I ever need it. But it's a very cool example of that sort of social structure in animals doing something like sharing that we often think of as a pretty purely human thing.